machine match here. This is one of the top performing bots in the competition. And I have with me two students from UC Berkeley. We have Evan, who's going to provide some commentary of this match. And we have Oriol, who was a former 2001 WCG participant. So what we should see here is very high-level gameplay of man versus machine in StarCraft. So groundbreaking match right here. And I look forward to it. So this is two students, and they're not affiliated with the university, but it's just an individual submission. It wasn't with any lab or university. So we're gonna kick off the match.
He's chasing. Oh, he's going to be by the door. Yes, yeah, 8 HP, but it's okay, don't regenerate, so they kind of heal. Yeah, like, then it's armor that you have. So it's this carapace, it's like human.
So what we see here is actually a mech built by the Terran, and they're going to be doing a lot of tanks and vultures and really kind of run over the Zerg before the Zerg gets too much of a resource infrastructure set up. So coming back to the Zerg, we see he's actually going to evolve to tier 2 tech here with his main structure, and that will allow for flying units that are going to find what he's going for. It's kind of his trademark. It's actually what one of the bots is based off, his analysis of Oriol's game flow is part of Berkeley's bot.
And I want to notice this. Oh my goodness, it's way fast. See, look at this critter, he's just trapped on top of this edge here.
So these guys followed the scout all the way up to the top left, and now they're headed over. Mission accomplished.
He has a kill.
So...
Oh, he's a bad guy.
So, he has this guy camped out here just to make sure that whenever the bot does pull out of his base, he'll be ready to either build more reinforcements or be more aggressive.
So the idea is you always want to extend your vision to as close to your opponents as possible. You don't want to be cooked up in your own base and when he comes, you cannot respond in time. You always want to extend to be in their face and to know when he's coming so you can respond. Because as you can see, when the scout is killed or landing something on the tower, you can see the spike from like under the ground. So you're just walking along the spike come on. So he's doing a bunch of those, and he's blocking the entrance with some drones to make sure the boats are now sneaking to his main base and kill a lot of people.
So we're going to be trying to hold off the opponent until this structure is out, which is this fire will allow him to build flying units. And there's also something interesting going on here, where the bots kind of use this structure to get additional vision of the opponent, which we don't normally see in the Terran vs. Zerg map, too.
If you go, it's okay, but the army's going to have no... This looks really bad for Terran. Yeah.
So that was hopeless. Some damage to the second colonies, but... Yeah. The Zerg's going to hold off and kill off his flying units before the Terran can really do any damage. So, the Terran does have some units ready to handle this, but we'll see whether the Zerg really just rolls over and runs away, or whether there's going to be something that comes inside the valley.
So that thing will actually make a lot of this, which are these really like these dudes with like shooting missiles out of their arms.
Yeah, it's very strong against them, yeah. So if the bot decides to go for that tech, they might be able to pull us off or something.
And all this thing sucks.
We have some huge shots
the Muslims are out, they're flying, they're like tiny birds. And then they're just coming and they shoot these bouncy, spiky things that bounce around you and kill you. So they're definitely very painful.
So I guess trying to get them well so we can maximize this damage output while taking them off minimal damage. And we're just. So here he comes in, he's gone.
If you play the Leica, you know, the ESPN, you could kind of hide your ship in the corner, shoot the base, and that's kind of what he's doing. And the Leica itself, he's trying to shoot the lizard skin. He made them angry. That was a bad one.
Yeah, all the bots pretty much destroyed at this point. bad manner